Hello, my name's Nicole, and I've been making YouTube videos for 5 years now.
I'm just too famous.
Okay,
why because
it was my turn to go,
alone?
And all of a sudden she thought she was gonna go.
Hi.
Hug.
I cannot explain what's going down. I can see you standing next to me.
I'm gonna call it last night. I'll figure out the title later, but
hey, vlog.
We are at Trailhead Brewing Company. We're getting lunch with the fam. It started smoking really bad, and I didn't really have anywhere to pull over.
Wait, should I do a whistle tone?
Oh my god!
Title it Maddie Barr's Ariana Grande.
Stop!
You seem so down today. What's going on in your life right now?
I always feel the need to preface this video by saying this isn't an April Fool's joke. I did in fact post my first ever video on April 1st. I didn't really plan for it to be like that. It just kind of happened. I really only planned on posting that one video and then not posting ever again, to be honest. My sister encouraged me to start making more videos more consistently. It's kind of weird to think that I started making videos when I was 16 years old, because I'm 21 now. When I was 16, I was a lot different than how I am now. I had different friends, I was in high school, and now I'm about to graduate college. When I started my YouTube channel, I was a child. Like, I was genuinely just a girl with a camera, pretty shitty camera. I really just wanted to make videos just because I wanted to make videos. I didn't really think about like, oh, I need to capture this moment, or oh, I think this would be good to have later on in life. But I feel like it's kind of turned into a scrapbook for me. I kind of stopped vlogging once I got to college because a lot of people don't know, I was made fun of and bullied for making YouTube videos in high school. I was kind of in this groove of not making videos because of COVID and everything. There was a lot said and a lot done that a lot of people don't even know, and I've kind of erased from my memory. While I had so much fun creating videos, I was kind of overshadowed by this really dark light of people just being negative. While I don't care about the negativity, and I didn't care back then, I don't care now, for a 16-year-old to hear the things that I heard, to just continue to do everything that they were talking about me and not to care, it just shows how strong I am and how resilient I am. You know, to go through what I went through in high school, not only in regards to my YouTube channel, but like, I was a junior in high school carrying a rolling backpack, and you can imagine what people were saying about me and doing to me. I'd be posting 3 times a week. You know, the day before I was supposed to upload a video, I'd be awake in my room till 2, 3 a.m. sometimes, be editing before I had to wake up at 6, 7 o'clock the next morning to go to school. And people don't see that side of it, and people don't see the reality of how hard I work. You go to high school for 7 hours a day, volleyball for 2, you come home, you edit videos, and you do your homework, and you just do that all the time, even on the weekends. And you just throw your heart and your soul into your YouTube channel. At least that's what I did, and that's what I continue to do. I don't make money from YouTube. I've never made a dime off of YouTube, but it doesn't really matter because I've been doing so much more than making money. But I went to the hospital earlier this year, if you didn't know, and all I could really think about was making YouTube videos and continuing to vlog my life and document my life. And I was so upset that I couldn't do that. Like, I missed the first week of my senior year, and all I was thinking about was continuing to create videos and continuing to post and just feeling like, oh my god, this is what I love to do. I just couldn't be more thankful for the 5 years that I've had on YouTube, I honestly didn't think I'd get to this point. I thought I might have quit sooner. And there were points in time when I wasn't posting. My channel was like dormant, I guess you could say. But even during those moments, I still thought about YouTube all the time. Like I was like, oh wow, like this would be fun to vlog. This would be fun to make a YouTube video out of. Even though I have less than 500 subscribers, I still consider myself that I grew up on YouTube because a big portion of my adolescence was YouTube and was the videos that I was creating. This year I've gained over 200 subscribers in 3 months, and that's all because of you guys and you liking my videos. But to anyone out there who's thinking of starting a YouTube channel in 2024, honestly do it. What do you have to lose? Who knows, you could create a job for yourself and more opportunities for yourself. I genuinely don't know how many opportunities my YouTube channel has given me. Like, I wrote it down on my resume. I've gotten multiple jobs from doing this. I thank people for the love that they've shown me and the kindness they've shown me. I love doing this. I would encourage you guys to just look at the positives of your situation. It does suck sometimes, and you have to look at that too. Keep doing the things you love, no matter what anybody says. If I didn't continue my YouTube channel, I wouldn't be where I am, and I wouldn't be doing the things I'm doing today, and I wouldn't have the courage to make videos, and I wouldn't have found my passion. Probably most of you know I'm doing a really big project this year where I post a video every single day of 2024. There's a lot of fun stuff coming up on my YouTube channel. I'm just thinking back to my old videos in that time in my life, and I truly don't regret anything. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell someone you love them and be kind to people. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace. I used to float, now